Hi everyone, Sonia here, and you're watching Pouring with Sonia, and I'm so geeked, so excited, because I got my sample of the This Little Piggy, and it's the color I really wanted, although I've seen so many colors now that I want them all, of course, the seaweed, the cappuccino, the tail feather, I just have to have them all, so, but we're going to play today with Grenache, and I thought I would show you how I mix up my piggies. If you're interested, and then I will pause and then we'll do a couple paintings. So basically what I've got for all of my pigments, I do my pouring, oh, this has got a hole in it. I do my pouring medium paint to the Jo Sonia varnish in a 4-to-1 ratio. If I'm going to do it, I mix up two containers, one that's for my pigments and that's a 4-to-1 ratio, and then one for paints. And paints is a 3-to-1 ratio. So I'm going to use the 4-to-1 ratio for this. I'm also going to use, I happen to have a deco art pouring medium. Any pouring medium will do, whatever kind you have. This is just what I happen to have on hand. And so you could use a Liquitex or whatever kind you have. But this is just what I've got, so I'm going to be using that. And then because I think it comes out a little thin, I add just a drop of an acrylic binder to mine as well, because that's not going to really change the color, but it's going to add a little bit of thickness. So let's just get started and I'll show you what I do if you're interested. So I'm just going to grab like a little heap here. Prop it there so it doesn't fall over, and put the lid right back on this so powder doesn't go everywhere. And I will do the same with my Grenache. I'm so excited for my Grenache. Oh, don't be this way to me. I can't even get it open. Yay! The excitement was building. Look at this, you guys. A nice truly rich red. Oh my goodness. I have trouble finding a good red. So I want to tap that down. I really should have on a little mask when dealing with pigments because those colors kind of fly everywhere, right? All right, so I'm going to grab, oh, she's so pretty. I'm going to go in and get a little bit more of that. Because they're not really super high scoops. Okay. Oh, I'm going to bring you in for a close-up of that. It's just, oh my gosh. All right. So the Grenache, just the pigment itself is, and you probably can't see that. I don't know if I have a light that will reach over. I don't know if you can see that. No, it's too far off. It's just a super deep, beautiful, beautiful rich red. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of my pouring medium. It's a little bit shaken up here. And literally just wet this. I don't want hardly anything at all. Just enough to kind of wet those pigments. So just a few drops, just a little bit. And I'm going to put that right in with my interference gold. Now, this ball gown, by the way, just a little bit. So I mixed up a little ball gown, and I used it in a tile that I'm going to use for a jewelry box. And then I ran out of it. I did three of them. I had one left to do, and I had some old interference gold by Golden that I used. I'm like, oh, that should be pretty much the same. I had it mixed up. It wasn't even close. This ball gown's crazy good. So I'm just mixing and mixing. I'm really just wanting to get my pigments a little bit wet so that they can start breaking down. And just stir it around until you don't see any lumps left or any clumps. You can try and scrape it off the sides here. Get it down in there. So it's not super thick, like a thick paste, but it's not runny. You can see that it's sitting on my stick, okay? And gloop, there it is, it's a gloopy. But it's not like a thick paste that won't, it's definitely still stirring around. So I'm gonna do the same thing with the gold. I'm just gonna kind of nudge it in there a little. You wanna go kind of slow until they get a little bit wet so that you don't have the powders flying around. Right, slowly, once they start getting, everything starts to get a little bit of that moisture on them, you can go a little more rapidly. Which is what I'm doing now because there's still a lot of lumps in it, so I'm just really mushing it around. And so now I can see, oops, there's a little bit of powder stuck there. And so now I can see, again, it's like a gloop, glop, but it's all gotten wet now. It's not a thick paste, you know, it's still, it's moving around nicely. Okay, so now to that, I'm gonna add just a little drop of this Bindex. That was like two drops and two drops, not much. But that's just gonna help it not be quite so thin. And I'm just gonna stir that around, add it on in there, stir it in. I'm not gonna worry about trying to scrape it off my stick just yet. I should have been more careful. I made sure that the binder didn't get on my stick, but it did. So I'm going to stir that around with the red. Okay. Because this right here is a little thin, I think. Okay. I don't want them to tip over. And a little trick for you, which probably most of you know, but you know, I mix this up in batches and then it could sit for a couple weeks. I mean, it could sit for a while. And so I always keep a little pantyhose stocking over the top so that if there's any clumps that have gotten clumped in there, they won't come out into my painting. So I've got a stocking on there. And now I don't measure, I just kind of put in what I think is gonna work. And do you like that measurement? And now I'm just going to stir this all up and you'll see, oh my goodness, these pigments, super rich, super beautiful, oh my gosh, mesmerizing is what they are. Now I can go back around and really get what maybe was stuck on the sides. And the consistency that I want, so that might even still be a little bit thin. I might add a little more binder to it because I want it to be thicker than my cell activator for one. Okay, I'm mixing up my ball gown. All mixed up real good. Okay, so I'm gonna want them to be a little bit thicker still because that was really, it's leaving a little bit of a mound. So I'm gonna do two more drops, maybe three of that. Okay. And I definitely want my paint to be like leaving a little bit of a mound. Stir, stir, stir. Okay, that's getting better. Let's do this one. Stir it up real good. So wet it with your pouring medium. And I'm not saying you have to use a binder. I'm sure plenty of people don't. But my particular, I don't think I use the standard norm. I use something from Ace Hardware. It's probably a different paint than what a lot of you use for your pouring medium. And so maybe yours is, it's plenty thick without it, but the consistency I want is something that's going to be thicker than my cell activator. Okay, so let's see. Let's see if I can get you to, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring this over a little bit, my little light, so that hopefully you can see better and have some light on there. And so it's drizzling off just fine. It's nice and streaming off fine. But when it gets down there, it forms a mound and then drops down. And it's got a little bit of a, and can you see that? Let me get this right here. So you don't want it to be too thin. And I still am like on the verge of. But it's definitely leaving a little bit of a mound now. Hopefully you can see that. It's not too bright. It probably is now for you. But for the red, I needed, I think, extra light. Okay, so hopefully you can see that a little, but it's leaving a little mound. Now, if I compare that to, I've got a black CA here that I think I'll use, which I mixed up a little bit earlier today. I'm going to give it another stir. And my, when I'm using the Australian Floetrol, this will last for a long, long time. But if I use the US one and I'm adding a bunch of ingredients to it, I need to make it up fresh and use it within a day or two. So this one, it doesn't leave as much of a mound. Do you see how it still comes off, but it just kind of drops. It's not, you see? So it's like, it creates a little cone, but it doesn't make a circle, 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 like a circly mound, and then drop down. It just drops. That's my cell activator. A little bit thinner than the piggies. Okay, so let's do a painting. Since you watched that, I think I'm going to do, I think I'm going to keep it simple at first and just do this with black on and spin one. And then I think I'm going to try and do like some copper and orange with this red. And we'll see what happens with the boom gel. So one that's all piggies and then one where I'm mixing some boom in with the piggies. So I'm going to pause this and when you come back, I will be ready to paint. Pause. Hi everyone, I'm back. And so I got my little doggy pool that I've lined with plastic and my little turntable. I haven't done a spinning bloom in a while. I've got my black pillow, which I've shaken up. I use the Sherwin-Williams Color to Go. They colored it for me tricorn black. And I add GAC 800, about a quarter cup of that, to one of these sample ports. And so I'm going to open that up. Oh, I'm glad it cooperated. And I'm going to use a black pillow. Okay. And I want plenty of pillow. Oops. I didn't mean to grab that there. I really flubbed it there at the end because I just wanted to get to within about an inch of each edge and I kind of blooped over, but you know, that's all right. And then I'm so messy. I see people out there that are so neat all the time. That is not me. However, oh, also just another little tip. I just put some painter's tape on the bottom of my board so you can see the green tape here. That's going to keep it from spinning off, okay? So I don't have to worry about losing it when I'm spinning. All right, so I have that on there. That's not super even. And so I think what might happen is this might slide off easier than the rest and distort things. So because I kind of had a gloopy there, I think I'm just gonna kinda just pull it out to the edges. I don't normally do this, but because I've got one that's already going off the edge there with a big amount of pillow, I'm sure I could just scrape it back in though, right? A little, and then not have that problem. But I didn't think about that because I was too busy gabbing with you, because you're fun to gab with. All right, so you don't have to do this little step here, but I just kind of wanted to even it out. All right, now I also am going to use my little Revlon. It is intended to have round brushes attachments. There's two sizes that attach to it. So it's just this little hot air blower, and it has three speeds. It has a cool, a low, and a high. And the cool is cool air, but it's high speed, and that's what I use. It's the first click. All right, let's just give this a little bit of a go. Just doing another quick little stir here of the Grenache. I'm going to put a pretty decent amount down because I'm just doing really just two colors here. And so I want to have kind of a lot, not skimping on the paint. Okay. And now I'm just going to put a black cell activator. So just trying to let the Grenache be the star of the show here, and we'll see how it goes. But really, I can't wait to kind of get some oranges and coppers mixed in there with it, too. Those are some big air bubbles. And I don't normally pop them, but they're just bothering me for some reason because they were extra big. Because I just stirred it right before I put it down. All right, so now I'm going to put the cell activator on top of that. Again, I'm not going to be shy with that. This is a big painting. And blow. When I blow, I don't go straight down. I try and go a little bit at an angle and skim it across the top. That's kind of what I do. Or I try to do. I'm going to leave it just like that. I'm not going to worry about that metal too much. I think a lot of it's going to come back up together. And if it doesn't, when I spin, it will change that also. So I'm going to give it a minute for that pillow to get back underneath and for those cells to kind of try and rejoin one another in the middle. I think I could use with a little bit thicker paint still because I've got very, very, very fine lacing here, which I don't mind either. I like the thick stuff and I like the thin stuff. I like it all. So look, there's just two colors on this with a black base and a black cell activator. And so many times that black will overpower or change the bottom color so much. Almost like the white lightens the colors, right? But it's just, it's this beautiful, the colors of the pigments, they are so true. And this ball gown is just amazing. I like I said, the golden couldn't even come close to it. So let's go on and give this a spin. I can see it's mostly all come to the gown. You saw how much black was in the middle there. And I'm just being patient and letting it come back into the middle. Holding this up a little bit because I don't have my apron on. Let's just give it a little gentle spin and see what we get. And then I can spin more if I need to. I love this cake turner. I think I am going to spin a little more. I think I could, like, this is beautiful just the way I want it, but I think I want to try and stretch out some of that a little. Though it's not terrible. I'm not going to go too crazy. Just a little. Yeah, I lost some of my gold up here. I didn't really want to lose. But that's okay. This is pretty cool looking. So what I want to do Because all you probably see right now is like red and white, but I'm going to show you. That's not what you're going to see. Really, you're going to see this beautiful red and gold. The gold, this ball gown is, it's probably going to be one of my favorites because it's unreal how great it is. All right, I'm going to bring you down. I'm just getting the paint off my gloves here, but I'm not going to take them all the way off because I'm going to do another painting after this. So if I'm right on top, it looks very like white. But as soon as you get a little onto the side, when the light hits it, you can see like here, it's like, oh, that's boring. No, no, no. It's so not boring. It's got this gold everywhere. And there's red and gold here. See how that gold? I know that, my light is, but that's the only way I can kind of show you here right now, is that all of that is going to be gold, red, and black. It's just super cool. It's all gold, red, and black. So I think that that's really going to be a beauty. I'm pretty happy with it. I like that I've got some. So look, I got some really big cells in the middle. And that's because I had all that black. And I let it just kind of absorb the cells back together with the pillow. So they're going to be bigger in the middle. Okay. Then I've got some kind of medium ones over here. There's still multiple that's gold and red and black all right there. Then just some kind of negative spacey type. Like this looks like there's not much going on, but it's really got this beautiful color shift of red and gold over that black. That red doesn't get lost at all. And when it dries, it doesn't change. It stays. It's really nice. And so anyway, some medium cells and then some really, look at this really delicate, it's not even like cells within cells. It's just really delicate lacing out here. I love the big bold lacing, but I like that this painting has all three of them. Okay. So, I think I might thicken up my red a little bit more for the next one and try it with, well, and I'll have my boom gel in the next one too. So that's going to change everything. So I hope that you had fun watching this one. And oh my gosh, first of all, the Grenache, it's, am I saying that right? Let me just pull it right here for you. Yeah, Grenache, G-R-E-N-A-C-H, the Grenache is amazing. If you're looking for like a really true rich red, well, here you have it. Look at that. And the ball gown is probably my favorite interference gold. It's way better than, say, the golden fluids. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be so pretty. I'm already pretty excited about it. And I actually don't mind that, again, I've got some little spaces here where there's not a ton going on. It kind of gives your eyes a little bit of rest. That's not going to be white at all. It's going to be all gold. So when it dries, oh my goodness, I'm going to like it a lot, I think. So anyways, I hope you had fun and maybe learned a few tips on how to mix up, how I mix up one way that you could mix up your piggies and pigment powders. If you find they're too thin, you can use a little bit of acrylic binder. Which doesn't really change the color. And then just some little tips and tricks and then a fun little painting. So until we meet each other again, have fun painting, everyone, and bye.